क्रतुंडमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषये भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं साक्षात्कृतं दयानंदं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्वज्ञान प्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदं। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ नमो भगवते वैवस्वताय मृत्यवे ब्रह्म विद्याचार्याय नचिकेतसे च। You can repeat from the shloka number 12. Yesha sarveshu bhuteshu.
Yesha sarveshu bhuteshu.
Gurudotmana prakashate.
Gurudotmana prakashate.
दृश्यते त्वग्रया बुद्ध्या।
दृश्यते त्वग्रया बुद्ध्या।
सूक्ष्मया सूक्ष्मदर्शिभिः।
सूक्ष्मया सूक्ष्मदर्शिभिः।
यच्चेत् वाङ् मनसि प्राज्ञः। तद्यच्चेज्ज्ञानमात्मनि। ज्ञानमात्मनि महति नियच्छेत्। तद्यच्चेच्छान्त आत्मनि। उत्तिष्ठत जाग्रत। प्राप्य वरान् निबोधत। शुभस्य धारा निशिता दुरत्यया। दुर्गं पतस्तद्गवयो वदन्ति। We have seen the Bhashyam to this shloka, 14th shloka, Uttishtata Jagrata. Now we have to see the Sangati to the next mantra. Through the shloka, through the mantra, 14th mantra, Upanishad says, the subject matter, that is Atma, it is Sukshma Vishaya. It is Sukshma Vishaya. And walk and knowing, understanding Atma is like walking on the razor's edge. The difficulties involved in this pursuit of jnanam and therefore moksha is presented by this mantra, 14th mantra. Kavayaha Vadanti, the wise people, Kavayaha, they talk of this pursuit as difficult as the walking on the razor's edge. Because unlike the other knowledge, this knowledge is not available for other pramanam, for objectification. And since the subject matter is ati sukshma, sukshmatvat, therefore, sukshma buddhi is required. For the person who has this samskrita buddhi, sukshma buddhi, for him, it will not be a difficult one. For the prepared ones, it will not be a difficult one. So, therefore, ati sukshmatvat, being very subtle, the subject matter is subtle subject matter, because subject matter is a very subject, and the subject is not available for objectification. It is not available as an object for knowing. The jnaya vastu being the very subject, therefore it is difficult, therefore it is difficult. Ati sukshmatvat, it is Dukkena Sampadaniyam Iti, this mantra says. Then the next mantra, why it is difficult to know, why it is difficult to understand, that is said by the next mantra, and Bhashyakara gives it Sangati. Sangati we will read, starting from the line, tat katam iti sukshmatvam,
tat katam iti sukshmatvam,
nyeyasya iti uchyate,
iti uchyate,
being said, what is being said, sukshmatvam, the subtleness, the subtlety, ati sukshmatvam, the extreme subtleness of the object or of the thing which is to be known, nyayasya. Object means not a physical object, that is the object which is to be known. That's what the meaning, nyayasya. Nyayasya, that which is to be known. What is to be known? Brahma, Atma. That is to be known. And tasya ati sukshmatvam asti. Since it is of the nature of extremely subtle, having the sukshmatvam, being of this being or having the status of being subtle, being subtle, sukshmatvam means being subtle. Being subtle, nyayasya of the thing which is to be known, that is Brahma, tat katam, how is that? How is that it is extremely subtle? Iti uchyate, that is being said. In the previous mantra, Bhashyakara I have said that it is very subtle. Therefore, the pursuit of jnanam, which deals with the sukshma atma, is difficult. Now, through this Sangati Bhashya, why it is ati sukshmatvam? That being said, ati sukshmatvam yayasya katam, how, of what nature is this, the subtle thing which is to be known? That being said, in this, the mantra. Why it is subtle? Why it is subtle? Atma is free from attributes. Attributeless. Atma is nirguna. That which has attributes, that which has qualities, that can be known as an object of knowledge. Like any object of knowledge, we can know a thing if it has attributes, if it has qualities. And when the properties becomes less and less, then the thing becomes more subtle. Lesser the attributes, lesser the grossness, and the subtlety increases. So they are inversely proportional. Lesser the attributes, greater the subtleness, and therefore lesser the grossness. When the grossness of a thing reduces, then it becomes difficult to objectify and know it. Any object which is available as an object of knowledge for us for objectification, it's because of the attributes of the objects. And if that reduces, then it becomes difficult to know. Therefore, Atma being Nirguna, it is Nirguna, therefore, free from attributes, therefore it is very difficult, all the more difficult. That is why it is Kshurasya Dhara Nishita Duratyaya. And here Bhashyakara will be saying in the Sangati, these Panchamaha Bhutas, starting from Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Apaha, Prithvi, these Panchamaha Bhutas, each Panchamaha Bhuta has got five attributes, five qualities, and the qualities keeps increasing starting from Akasha onwards. And the Prithvi has the maximum number of qualities, the maximum number of attributes. And in Taittiriya Upanishad, in the Srishti Prakaranam, how these Panchamaha Bhutas come into existence from Atma is mentioned. Tasmat, etasmat, akashaha sambhutaha, etasmat atmanaha, akashaha sambhutaha, akashat vayuhu, vayor agnihi, agneer apaha, apuf prithvi, atmanaha, brahmatmanaha, akashaha sambhutaha, akasha came into existence from akasha vayu to agni, from Agni to Apaha, and final is Prithivi. Prithivi, which is the last one, which in the series of the creation, the evolution, the series of creation, Prithivi is the last one, evolved from the previous element, Panchamahabhuta. Prithivi is the last one, which has all the five properties, five gunas. Shabdadi Vishaya Panchakam. Shabdadi Gunakam. Shabdadi Gunaka. Pancha Shabdadi गुणकम अस्ति पृथिव्या पृथ्वी हैज गॉट ऑल दी फाइव क्वालिटीज फाइव एट्रीब्यूट्स देयरफॉर इट इज ग्रॉसेस्ट पृथ्वी हैज शब्द स्पर्श रूप रस गंध इट इज अवेलेबल फॉर शब्द पृथ्वी मेक्स साउंड एंड पृथ्वी इज अवेलेबल फॉर टच इट हैज गॉट अ फॉर्म इट हैज टेस्ट and it has gandha. Gandha is a main property. Other four properties are derived from the previous elements out of which the prithvi is born. This is the order. And if you go to the other element, which is one before the prithvi, that is apaha, water, which has got four elements, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa. Compared to prithvi, apa has got only four. Therefore, it is relatively less grosser, or the subtle, relatively more subtle. Rasa is the main attribute of water, apaha. Whereas shabda, sparsha, rupa, these have come from the previous elements. These qualities have come from the previous elements, akasha, vayu, agni. And if you take the vayu, agni, if you take the one which precedes the water, agni has got form. The quality, the attribute of agni is rupa. Form, shape, color, rupa. Agni doesn't have rasa. Agni doesn't have gandha, but it has got shabda, sparsha, rupa. Rupa is its own quality, attribute, guna, whereas shabda and sparsha derived from the previous elements, panchamakabhuta, tanmatras. Therefore, agni is more grosser than the prithvi and relatively grosser than the water. And now the previous element to Agni is Vayu, whose guna is Sparsha. Therefore, Vayu has its own guna, Sparsha, and the guna of Akasha. So, Shabda, Sparsha, Gunatmakaha, Akashaha. So, Akasha has got these two gunas, Shabda and Sparsha. Therefore, compared to Prithvi, it is more subtle, very less grosser compared to prithvi. It is very subtle compared to apaha. It is relatively subtle compared to rupa, still relatively subtle. It is subtle than the prithvi, and therefore it is less grosser. Therefore, the number of properties reduces. Therefore, it is not available for easy objectification. The objectification also reduces. The number of properties increases, then the more the number of properties, the more it is available for objectification as an object. Then the previous element is Akasha, whose property is Shabda, which doesn't have any of the other four gunas, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. So Akasha's quality is only Shabda. It is the only quality Akasha has. Therefore, it is subtlest. Among these five, it is subtlest. And it is very subtlest, and therefore it is not grosser. Compared to Sparsha, it is less grosser. Compared to Prithvi, it is very less grosser. Not available. Not Akasha, not available for objectification, like other objects which are available for your objectification. And what is before Shabda? Atmanaha. Etasmat, tasmat, etasmat, atmanaha. What is before there, before Shabda is, that is Akasha is Atma. Atma is in fact all the way. Akasha, from Akasha Shabda came, and from Atma plus Akasha Sparsha, Atma plus Akasha plus Vayu gives Agni. So this Atma is all the way, and Atma is the Karanam. It is the Karanam. And these five Pancha Maha Bhutas have got the attributes, and we have seen the number of attributes getting lesser and lesser, and when it goes to Atma, Atma is the subtlest of all. So therefore, it is not available for objectification. Since it is the subtlest of all, and therefore it has no attributes, at least Akasha has got one attribute, but Atma doesn't have even that. So it is Nirgunam, Nirguna Atma. So therefore, Ati Sukshmatvam Atmanaha Nyayasya Vastunaha Atmanaha Ati Sukshmatvam Asti. This is what in the Sangati Bhashyakara is going to present. So now we can read. Stula.
Stula.
Avadiyam Medini.
Avadiyam Medini. Medini.
Shabdasparsha Rupa Rasa Gandopachita. सर्वेन्द्रिय विषय भूता तथा शरीरम् मेदिनी इयं मेदिनी स्थूल इयं मेदिनी स्थूल This Medini. Medini means Prithivi. Prithivi is called Medini. Medha means Grahana Dharana Shakti, Mahaprana Dha, that is different. Here Medha, Kalpa Prana. Medha means fat. So Medini is that which has fatness. Therefore it is easily available for your objectification. So Medini, Iyam Medini. Iyam Medini Stula. This Medini is Stula. It is gross. Why it is gross? Because Medini Prithivi has got all the five gunas. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, Upachita. Upachita is collected, accumulated or conglomeration of these five gunas. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, Upachita, Iyam Medini. Yam Medini Shabdasparsha Rupa Rasa Gandopachita. One sentence. Shabdasparsha Rupa Rasa Gandopachita Yam Medini. Then Sarvendriya Vishaya Bhuta. Because it has got all the Pancha Gunakam, therefore it is available for objectification to all the sense organs. It is the object of all the sense organs, five sense organs, Sarvendriya. All five organs of perception, they can objectify the Prithivi because it is the grossest. So the grossness, how do you measure the grossness? The grossness is measured in terms of its availability for the perception of sense organs. Prithivi is available for all the sense organs. And apaha is not available for the nasika, for nose. Granendriyam, apaha is not available. So one sense organ less. It is available only for the four sense organs, excepting granendriyam. Then if you take Agni is available for only three sense organs. Because it has got three properties, therefore three sense organs. Prithivi has got all the five properties, therefore available for all the five sense organs. Apaha has got only four properties, therefore available for four sense organs. Agni, three, therefore available only for three sense organs. It is not available for Granendriya. It is not available for Rasanendriya, taste. So tongue and ear. With this, you cannot objectify, you cannot understand water. Water doesn't have taste. Water is tasteless. The tasteness of the water is because of the prithvi. Then we have this Agni. Agni has got three, therefore available only for three sense organs. It is available up to the Netrendriya. For Netram, it is available, Agni. For Sparsha and Shrotrendriya, it is available for hearing. So similarly, if you go down further and further, Akasha is the last one, and only it is got only one property, Shabda. Therefore, it is available only for the Shrotrendriya. So Akasha is only for Shrotrendriya, and when you further go in the sequence of the elements which are formed from Akasha, that is Shabda, Akasha, Vayuhu, Agnihi, Apaha, then it is more and more available for the other sense organs. And Prithvi available for all the sense organs. Therefore, it is grossest. So, the grossness or the subtleness is measured in terms of its availability for the sense organs. Since Akasha, it's available only for Shrotrendriya, only one sense organ. Therefore, it is subtler. And Prithvi available for all the sense organs. Therefore, it is grossest. So, the more the availability for sense organs, that depends. That is a determining factor for the grossness or the subtleness. Now, this Sarvendriya Vishaya Bhuta, which one? Akasha, sorry, Medini, Prithivi. Sarvendriya Vishaya Bhuta, Prithivi. So, because Medini is there, Yam Medini, Shabda Sparsha Rupa Rasa Gandopachita, and Sarvendriya Vishaya Bhuta. Sarvendriya Vishaya Bhuta, Medini. This Prithivi is available for objectification to all the indriyas, all the sense organs. Tata shariram, in the same way shariram also. As the prithvi is available for all the five sense organs, so too the shariram. Why? Because shariram is also stulam. Tata medini stula, tata shariram api stulam. Sarvendriya Vishaya Bhuta Medini. Yata Sarvendriya Vishaya Bhuta Medini Tata Shariram Api. Therefore, as the Prithivi, so the Shariram. Therefore, Shariram is also nothing but Prithivi only. It is available for all the sense organs. It has got all the five properties. You can see the body, you can see the Shariram, you can touch, you can smell, it makes sound also. So, all the pancha gunas are there in the shariram. Therefore, it is available for objectification for all the sense organs. Now, Bhashyakara says, what will happen if you reduce the number of properties, number of qualities? If you keep reducing, what will happen? That Bhashyakara says. Tatra. एकैक गुणापकर्षेण
एकैक गुणापकर्षेण
गंधादीनां सूक्ष्मत्व महत्व विशुद्धत्व नित्यत्वादितारतम्यं
दृष्टम्
Abadishu Yavat Akashamiti
Akashamiti
Te Gandadhayaha स्थूलत्वात् विकार स्थूलत्व स्थूलत्वात् विकाराः शब्दान्ताः यत्र न सन्ति किमूतस्य सूक्ष्मत्वादि निरतिशयत्वम् वक्तव्यम् इति एतत् दर्शयति श्रुतिः श्रुतिः दर्शयति श्रुति शोस् बै वाट् बै द नेक्स्ट् मन्त्र 15th मन्त्र सो तत्र तत्र इस् देर् इन् दिस् तत्र तत्र एकैक गुण अपकर्षणेन गुणापकर्षणं गुणापकर्षणं मीन्स् रिमूवल् आफ् गुणास् एकैक मीन्स् वन् बै वन् रिमूविङ्ग् दि गुणास् वन् बै वन् रिमूविङ्ग् दि गुणास् वन् बै वन् विल् इन्क्रीस् दि सटल्नेस् विल् इन्क्रीस् दि सटल्नेस् द सटल्टि विल् इन्क्रीस् and therefore the pervasiveness also will increase. Prithivi is grosser and therefore it is not all pervasive. The pervasiveness of Prithivi compared to water or other elements, it is less. Akasha is the subtlest, Prithivi is the grossest, and therefore Akasha is more pervasive than the Prithivi. The number of gunas, the lesser the number of gunas, the more will be the subtlety and the pervasiveness. So ekaika guna apakarshanena, apakarshanam is removal, so removal of one by one gunas, one by one gandha adina, that is gandha etc. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, these five Gandha Adina. Because Guna Apakarshanam is there, therefore he says Gandha Adina. Doesn't say Shabda Adina. You have to start from Gandha for removing the Gunas. Gandha, you remove it, then the other four Gunas will be remaining. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa. Rasa, you remove it, then three Gunas will be remaining. So you have to start from the Gandha, the reverse order. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, this is general order, but now we are starting from Gandha, the reverse order. Therefore, Gandha Adina, not Shabda Adina. From Shabda, if you remove the Guna, what is left out? I think it's left out. Nirgunam only is left out. Therefore, it is not Shabda Adina, it is Gandha Adina. The word is also very properly is used here, Gandha Adina. Gandha Adina. सूक्ष्मत्व महत्व विशुद्धत्व नित्यत्वादि तारतम्य देयर इज अ ग्रेडेशन द ग्रेडेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ सूक्ष्मत्वम द स्टेटस ऑफ बीइंग सटल सूक्ष्मत्वम सटलिटी महत्वम महत्वम इज पर्वेसिवनेस विशुद्धत्वम इज शुद्धत्वम प्योरिटी द मोर दिस द इट इज सटल द मोर इट विल बी प्योर. The more it is gross, then less will be the purity, Vishuddhattvam. And Nityattvam also. Nityattvam is only an apekshika Nityattvam, not the Nityattvam like the Atma. Nityattvam is, it is permanent, but more permanent. Because more subtle, therefore more permanent. Why more permanent? Because it is not available for the destruction, easy destruction. Prithvi available for five sense organs, and therefore it is available for objectification, therefore it is available for destruction also, more destruction. Whereas Akasha, it is subtle, available only for one sense organ, therefore it is not easily available for change or for the destruction. Therefore, nityatvam, relatively more permanent. Akasha is relatively more permanent. Prithvi is less permanent. So nityatvam also differs. There is a gradation. So a thing which is subtle is more permanent than the thing which is gross or grossest. In the srishti prakriya, starting from akasha up to prithvi. Now in the laya prakriya, what happens? That is during the pralaya time, the reverse process, that is the prithvi goes back to apaha, goes back to agni, agni to vayu, and vayu to akasha. So the destruction starts from prithvi, not from akasha. The destruction starts from prithvi. So prithvi is the first one which undergoes resolution during pralaya. Therefore it is less permanent. Nityatvam for prithvi is less compared to the nityatvam of akasha. Akasha is the final one which will be resolved. The first which is getting resolved, which will be getting resolved, is the prithvi. Therefore there is a taratamyam in terms of sukshmatvam, mahatvam, vishuddhatvam, and nityatvam. There is a gradation. Taratamyam, it is drishtam eva, it is drishtam, it is seen. So ekaika gunapakarshana gandadinam sukshmatvadi tarutamyam drishtam, it is seen. Where? Abadishu. What is abadishu? Up is water. Up adishu, abadishu. Abadishu yavat, yavat akasham iti. Abadishu yavat, yavat akasham iti. That is abadishu in water. In water, because why he says water? Abadishu akashamiti. Why he says start from water, not from prithvi? Because prithvi is already gross. Therefore, prithvi is gross, means it is the grossest. Therefore, there is no subtlety with prithvi. So when we say sukshmatvam, therefore we have to start from akasha. From water. The one which is before prithvi, abadishu. Therefore, since earth is already gross, therefore the taratamyam, when we talk, start from abadishu, start from water onwards, not from prithvi, because prithvi is the grossest. There is no subtlety with regard to prithvi. So we have to start from that which is subtler. Prithvi is the grossest. Compared to prithvi, up is less grosser and it is the subtlest. So therefore, start from water, not from prithvi. So abadishu, starting from water, yavat, going up to the akasham, akasham iti. Akasham is the subtlest. So the subtler is up and the subtlest is akasha. So going from water, that is up to the akasha. Abadishu yavat akasham iti te gandadayaha, that is the qualities which start from smell, gandadayaha up to shabdantaha, up to the shabda, the sound, which is the property of akasha. So going in the reverse order, from ganda up to the sound, from smell to the sound, shabda. So what happens? Ganda is the first thing which goes. Ganda is the first thing which goes. Then ganda stands for prithvi. So prithvi. Then comes water. Water is rasa. Then it goes away. So ekaika gunapakarshanena, what happens? This sukshmatvam increases. Going in the reverse order, sukshmatvam increases. Therefore, sarva eva, all these are स्थूलत्व विकाराः शब्दान्ताः यत्र न सन्ति. Therefore, these qualities, which are the cause for bringing about the grossness, stulatva vikaraha, starting from gandadayaha shabdantaha yatrana santi, in which it is not there, that is atma, and therefore that will be sukshmatvadi niratishayatvam vaktavyam. Therefore, atma, in which there are no such qualities, gandharayaha, shabdantaha, starting from ganda up to the shabda, these attributes are not there in atma. What to talk about atma? Kima vaktavyam sukshmatvadi niratishayatvam. Sukshmatva, the subtleness. Niratishayatvam means there is nothing about atma. There is nothing greater than the atma in terms of subtlety, in terms of shuddhatvam, in terms of mahatvam. So, why? Because atma is free from attributes. Nirgunam atma. Therefore, atma has nityatvam, shuddhatvam, sukshmatvam, mahatvam, tat vaktavyam. That has to be told, that is presented by the next mantra, Shudihi Darshayati. So the subtleness, the sukshmatvam, mahatvam, vishuddhatvam, nityatvam, niratishayatvam, atmanaha, vaktavyam iti, Shudihi Darshayati. Shudhi presents atma, which has sukshmatvam, sukshmatvam, magatvam, vishuddhatvam, that is going to be presented by the next mantra of the Shruti. Now we can read the mantra. Very important mantra. The similar mantra is there in Mundakopanishad in the very beginning itself. In Katopanishad, it comes in the third section of the first chapter, whereas in Mundakopanishad, in the first chapter itself, Pratama Mundaka, in Pratama Kanda itself, it comes. Through all these mantras, Shruti trying to define the indefinable, describe the indescribable. Nirgunam Atma, how it can be described, Shruti attempts to convey through some words. The words negate the possibilities. Neti neti iti prakriya. So we will read the mantra. Ashabdam asparsham arupam avyayam. Tatarasam nityam agandha vachayat. Anadyanantam magatav param dhruvam. Nichayatan mrittimukat pramuchyate. Ashabdam asparsham arupam avyayam. It's all male, no? You have to split to understand. Sandhi has not happened. It is only male. Ashabdam asparsham arupam avyayam tata arasam. Sandhi, here, dirgha sandhi. Tata arasam, no rasa. Everywhere it is ashabdam asparsham nanj is there, tatpurusha, nanj tatpurusha samasa, not shabda, not sparsha, not rupa. Avyayam, tata, rasam you cannot say. When shabda, sparsha, all these are not there. What about rasa? Rasa will be there. Tata, arasam, not rasam. Tata, arasam. Savarna dirgha sandhi. Nityam, agandam, agandavat. Agandavat cha yatu. Anadi, anantam. Mahataha, param, dhruvam, निचाय तत् मृत्युमुखात् प्रमुच्यते मृत्युमुखात् प्रमुच्यते सो इन दिस मंत्र यू कैन सी टू थिंग्स वन इज द नेचर द स्वरूपम ऑफ आत्मा विच इज प्रेजेंटेड बाय ऑल दीज वर्ड्स अशब्दम अस्पर्शम अरूपम अव्ययमिति एंड द सेकंड थिंग इज हाउ दिस आत्मा this atma what is the phalam of knowing this atma one is atma swarupa second one atma gyana phalam these are the two things talked about atma swarupa brahma swarupam is talked about and brahma gyana phalam now let us take the first one ashabdam before getting to the bhashyam we will see understand the words ashabdam Ashabdam means na shabdam ashabdam na shabdam ashabdam shabda means sound so therefore that shabda tattva rahitam shabda tattva rahitam ashabdam soundless shabda means soundless it means it is free from the guna sound it is free from the guna sound so shabda guna not there so atma will not make any sound there is no sound for atma it is silent no sound so atma gyanam is not through sound any sound even through the omkaran uchcharanam atma gyanam will not happen This is a saguna upasana. Atma is without sound. So, free from sound. Brahma doesn't have any shabda. Ashabdam. Then asparsham. Sparsha means touch. Sparsha means touch. Asparsham means free from touch. Atma is free from touch. Asparsham. Sparsha is the guna of the vayu so vayu gunakam sparsham na vidyate not there for atma sparsha tattva rahitam so ashabdam asparsham okay then arupam rupa is form shape or color Form, shape, or color. In general, it is available for this the netrendriya, chakshu. An atma doesn't have form, therefore atma cannot be seen. It cannot be seen through netrendriya. Not available for shabda, shrotrendriya. Not available for sparsha, that is for touch. For skin, it is not available. Skin perception. For skin perception, it is not available, and it is arupam doesn't have form. Therefore, it is not available for chakshurindriya also. It cannot be seen. So, anything which is seen cannot be atma. Any vision cannot be atma, because atma doesn't have form. So, how can you see it? So, now we have to take the arasam. Arupam, avyayam, avyayam we will come later. Arasam, you can take first all the pancha gunaka. Pancha gunakams are negated. Pancha gunas are negated for atma. First we will take ashabdam, asparsham, arupam. Then we can take arasam. Rasa means taste. That which is taste is tasty. That's why it's called rasam, I think. Rasa must be tasty. And atma doesn't have rasa. So it is free from taste. You cannot taste it. It is not available for jihva. Not available for rasanendriya. You cannot taste it and understand atma. Free from taste also. Atma is not sweet. It is not salty also. So tongue doesn't have any role. You cannot know it through rasanendriya. then ganda agandavat ganda smell agandavat vat is that which has the ganda that is called gandavat na gandavat agandavat free from smell so all the pancha gunas are not there for atma therefore pancha gunas these five gunas not there for atma so therefore ashabdam asparsham arupam arasam agandam it stands for gunahina gunahinam atma gunaragitam atma is brahma is gunaragitam so gunaragitam free from gunas then avyayam na vyeti iti avyayam na vyeti that which cannot which doesn't change is called avyaya that which doesn't change is called avyaya free from any change free from any change free from decay that is called avyaya and therefore atma is nityam it is nityam this since it doesn't undergo any change therefore it is nityam and atma is anadi anadi is free from beginning adi adi is beginning you can take the meaning of the word adi as karanam also so atma doesn't have karanam free from karanam karana ragitam atma is avyayam apakshaya ragitam and therefore nityam and atma is nityam it doesn't have karanam doesn't have beginning beginningless atma therefore doesn't have karanam anadi anantam means that which has no end endless anantam the word anta can be taken as the product anantam is atma is not a product atma anantam it is free from any effect it's neither the karanam nor the effect anantam antaha na vidyate yasmin anantam so free from cause and free from the cause and effect free from beginning free from end anadi anantam free from beginning free from end it means free from the cause and also free from any effect then magataha param magataha we are familiar with the word magataha magataha stands for this samashti buddhi hiranyagarbha param it is greater than it is distinct greater from hiranyagarbha that is samashti buddhi dhruvam is that which is kutastam changeless that which is changelessly constantly present permanent that is dhruvam nichaya ni is nischaya ni stands for nischaya nichaya means having known having understood nichaya is sakshat kritya having known nichaya tat is brahma atma nichaya having understood clearly mrityumukat pramuchyate from the mukha from the mouth of mrityu is death from the mouth of death the person is freed having known this atma understood this atma as ashabdam asparsham arupam ityadi a person is free from death he free from maranam he understand himself to be that which is free from any change therefore where is maranam for him so maranam is not there therefore samsara not there maranam mrityu stands for samsara mrityu stands for samsara and samsara is samsara avidya kama karma these are the thing which binds a person samsara so samsara not there so therefore the person becomes free he understands himself to be free from any change he understands himself to be limitless. He doesn't have kartrutvam. So kartrutvam is not there. Therefore, there is no kama. And therefore, no avidya. Avidya is also not there. Therefore, samsara is not there for the person. Therefore, the person is free from mrityu. So mrityu stands for all this. Samsara, avidya. So it is not there for the person. Since he knows himself to be Atma, which is doesn't have any vikara, therefore no karma, therefore no kama, because there is no karma, therefore no punya papam, and therefore there is no kama also, because he discovers himself to be limitless purnam, therefore there is no desire left out in him, in the person, to be achieved. So no kama, and no kama, therefore the person has no avidya, because he has got knowledge, this knowledge, therefore no avidya. So there is no samsara for the person. He is free from the samsara. The word samsara, the word mrityu stands for samsara, avidya, kama, karma. The samsara, avidya, kama, karma. Avidya, kama, karma is an expression. It goes together. Avidya, kama, karma. So mrityu mukhat is avidya, kama, karmanaha. Pramuchyate, it becomes free. It becomes free. Now, the Bhashyam. Ashabdam.
Ashabdam.
Asparsham.
Asparsham. Asparsham.
Arupam.
Arupam.
Avyayam.
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 Tatha arasam. व्याख्यातं ब्रह्म अव्ययम् तत् व्याख्यातम् तत् व्याख्यातम् ऑलरेडी बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड इति ब्रह्म तत् व्याख्यातम् ऑलरेडी बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड व्याख्यातम् भाष्यकार हिमसेल्फ भाष्यकार सिंपली सेज शब्दम स्पर्शम रूपम ऑलरेडी आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड दिस इन द संगति भाष्य यू देयरफॉर यू प्लीज रेफर देयर सो भाष्यकार डजंट से दैट ही विल नॉट एक्सप्लेन अगेन बिकॉज़ ऑलरेडी बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द संगति इटसेल्फ व्याख्यातम् यत् मया व्याख्यातं ब्रह्म अशब्दं स्पर्शं अरूपं अव्ययं तथा अरसं फ्री फ्रॉम साउंड दैट इज दैट्स गॉट नो साउंड प्रॉपर्टी देयरफॉर द नेक्स्ट वन इज अस्पर्शं फ्री फ्रॉम द क्वालिटी ऑफ टच अरूपं डजंट हैव फॉर्म देन अरसं फ्री फ्रॉम टेस्ट अगंधवत फ्री फ्रॉम स्मेल एंड अव्ययम इट इज डजंट अंडरगो एनी डीके And it is nityam. It is nityam. So that Brahma, which is nirguna, vyakhyatam. It is vyakhyatam, already explained. Already been explained. Here the vyakhyatam can also be taken the other way. It is kya means to tell. So vyakhyatam is. Brahma is that which cannot be objectified by any of the gunas. Therefore, Brahma is ashabdam asparsham arupam iti. That meaning also can be taken. So, Brahma is free from all this guna. Agandavat, the last one, agandavat. Gandavat, vatu pratyaya. Gandaha asya asti iti gandavat. Na gandavat. Agandavat. Nanch Tatpurusha Samasa. All these are Nanch Tatpurusha Samasa. Na Shabdam, Na Sparsham, Na Rupam, Na Rasam, Na Gandavat. Now Bhashyakara will say, Bhashyakara will try to connect the each words. These five gunakas are not, the gunams are not there. Therefore what? So you will see the connection. Vashikara will present the connection. You can read. Yadhi.
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 Shabdadimat.
शब्दादिवत्
तत् व्येति
तत् व्येति
शब्दादिमत् मत् प्रत्यय दैट व्हिच हैज दैट इज द मीनिंग शब्दादिमत् दैट व्हिच हैज शब्दादि शब्द स्पर्श रूप रस गंध दिस पंच गुण दिस पंच गुण व्हिच हैज शब्दादिमत् तत् व्येति तत् व्येति दैट विल चेंज दैट विल डीके व्हिच विल डीके दैट व्हिच हैज दिस फाइव गुणास starting from shabda sparsha starting from shabda only this will change what about brahma which doesn't have therefore doesn't change therefore it is called avyayam that is going to say idam idam tu
idam
idam tu
idam tu, idam tu ashabdadimatvat
idam tu ashabdadimatvat
avyayam
अव्ययम्
न व्येति न क्षीयते
न व्येति न क्षीयते
सो इदं तु वेरस हियर इदं तु वेरस अशब्दादिमत्पात् शब्दादिमत् शब्दादिमत् मीन्स शब्द शब्दादि शब्दादि अस्ति संति शब्दादि संति यस्मिनिति शब्दादि संति यस्मिनिति और अस्य इति शब्दादि मत तस्य भावः शब्दादि मत्वम् The status of having these qualities is called शब्दादि मत्वम् न शब्दादि मत्वम् अशब्दादि मत्वम् Because of that तस्मात् पंचमी शब्दादि मत इज शब्दादि शब्दादिहि संति यस्मिन् इति शब्दादि मत तस्य भावः शब्दादि मत्वं पंचमी तस्मात् शब्दादि मत्वात् एंड नञ्ज न शब्दादि मत्वात् बिकॉज़ इट इज फ्री फ्रॉम हैविंग द स्टेटस और बीइंग free from having the status of this quality shabdadi matvam therefore brahma is avyayam na vyeti brahma is avyayam na vyeti na kshiyate it doesn't decay it doesn't undergo any change there is it doesn't diminish doesn't fall apart it is because it is free from the qualities therefore avyayam vyayah na vidyate यस्य सः अव्ययः देयर इज नो चेंज इन चेंज फॉर दैट इज कॉल्ड अव्ययम् सो देयरफॉर न क्षीयते डजंट डीके सो आत्मा इज फ्री फ्रॉम द शब्दादि गुण देयरफॉर इट इज अव्यय दैट इज अ कनेक्शन देन द नेक्स्ट लाइन अत एव च नित्यम् Therefore, it is nityam. Why it is nityam? Because na vyeti, it is avyayam. Avyayatvat nityam. Because it is avyaya, therefore it is nityam, permanent. Yad hi vyeti.
Yad hi vyeti.
Tat anityam.
Tat anityam.
Yat vyeti tat anityam. That which vyeti undergoes that which decays undergoing changes decay that which diminishes that is anityam what is anityam that which decays that is called anityam atma is free from vyaya therefore nityam idam tu na vyeti atah anityam
na vyeti atah anityam
idam tu na vyeti atma na vyeti therefore it is therefore nityam
not anityam
it is nityam idam tu na vyeti atah nityam atma doesn't change doesn't undergo any change doesn't decay therefore it is nityam not anityam idam tu na vyeti atah nityam Then the next line. Itascha nityam.
Itascha nityam.
Anadi avidyamanaha adihi karanam asya.
Anadi avidyamanaha adihi karanam asya.
Tad idam anadi.
Tad idam anadi.
Itascha. Itascha because of the reason. Because of the reason, itascha, because of the following reason, the going reason going to come. Itascha nityam, because of the following reason. Atma is nityam. What is the reason? Atma is anadi. Atma is anadi. Anadi. Na adi. Na adihi anadi. Adi can mean the beginning. Adi can be the beginning. Na adihi, that is absence of the beginning. Anadihi. And Bhashyakara says, avidyamanaha adihi. Avidyamanaha absence. Absence of adihi. And adihi, he gives a meaning. Karanam. Cause. So there is no cause. There is no cause for the Atma. Atma is, Atma doesn't have a karanam. In fact, it is the karanam. It is the karanam for everything and it itself doesn't have a karanam. Atma is the karanam for everything, but it doesn't have karanam. It doesn't have a karanam, that is negated. The next one. So, the anadihi, anadihi is na adihi, avidyamanaha adihi, adihi is karanam, na vidyate, therefore tat idam anadi. Therefore, that is anadi, beginningless. Which is beginningless? That which is free from the cause is called anadi. So, anadi means causeless. It is the cause, but it is causeless. It is not created. Therefore, Atma is free from cause, anadi. Because it is causeless, therefore it is nityam. Because it is causeless, therefore it is nityam. All these words, they are not new. Already we have seen in the Gita. The Gita itself, through different words, Bhagavan Krishna in the second chapter, he presented, we have seen. Avyaya is that which is indestructible. Avyaya, avinashi. Avinashi tu tadviddhi. Ena sarvamidam tatam. Vinasham avyayasyasya nakaschit kartum argati. And it is free from adi anta. Antavantaha ime degaha. Nityasyokta sharirinaha. Anashinaha aprameyasya. Tasmad yudhyasva bharata. And because it is anadi, it is ananta. Therefore it doesn't have birth, it doesn't have death. Therefore na jagate na mriyate va kadachit. Nayam bhutva bhavita vana bhuyaha. It is ajaha, not born. It is not created. Therefore, it is nityaha. Ajo nitya shashvatoyam puranaha. Na hanyate anyamane sharire. Through all these shlokas, this melody we have seen in the Gita, how Bhagavan Krishna, he presents Atma Tattva. And this shabd, ashabda asparsha arupa rasaganda, that also Bhagavan Krishna presented through the shlokas. Nainam chindanti shastrani, nainam dagati pavakaha, na chainam kleda gintyapaha, na shoshayati marutaha. When he says it is not available for cutting for the shastra, for the weapons, not available for the pavaka, the agni to burn. It means it is not available for. It is not available for any of the sense organ. It is not available for any change which can be brought about, by Pancha Mahabhuta, because it is the cause of everything. So anything which has come out of Pancha Mahabhuta, the five elements, that cannot bring about a change in Atma. Therefore, it is nityam. It is avyaya. So you can connect this shloka with the shlokas of the Gita, starting from the the 11th shloka up to the 30th shloka. The whole shloka, the number of shlokas which are there, this covered in a condensed way in this shloka, this one shloka. Okay, then the next line of Divashyam. Yet.
Yet.
Yet
he.
Adimat.
Adimat.
Tat.
Tat.
Karyatvat.
Karyatvat.
Nityam karane praliyate. Yatha prithivyadi.
Yatha prithivyadi.
Idam tu sarva karanatvat akaryam.
Idam tu sarva karanatvat akaryam.
Akaryatvat anityam.
Akaryatvat anityam.
Na tasya karanam asti yasmin priliyeta. So here, why Atma is Nityam? Another reason being given. Itascha Nityam. Itascha Nityam. Because of this reason also, Atma is Nityam. It is Nityam. Why? The reason is Anadi. It doesn't have cause. Not having cause. Now, Bhashyakara here explains how not having cause will lead to Nityatvam. Will lead to Nityatvam. Yet he Adimatu. Adimatu is having beginning. Adimatu. Adihi. Asya asti. Adimatu. Adimatu, that which has a beginning, that's called Adimatu. Adihi. Asya asti. Adimat. Na Adimat, Anadimat. Na Adimat, Anadimat. Doesn't have a beginning. Tat Karyatvat Anityam. Karyatvat Anityam. That which has a beginning is a Karya, it's a product. That a product comes into existence. A product comes into existence, stays for a particular period of time, and then it resolves back into the cause. So a product is that which has got a beginning. Why a thing has got Adimata? Karyatvat. It gives a hetu. The hetu is Karyatvat. Being a product, therefore it has a beginning. Being a product, it has a beginning. What? Anityam. That which is Anityam, that which is Anityam is called Karyam. Why? Because it has got a beginning. But Atma is not a Karya. Karyatvat, therefore, Akaryatvat, therefore Nityam. Akaryatvat Nityam, Atma, Karyatvat Anityam, all the other things. All the other things. In the world, what we observe, anything we observe in the prapancha, a product, is Anityam because of being a product. Because of being a product, therefore it has got a beginning. It comes into existence at a particular time. So therefore, Karyatvat Anityam, but Atma is Akaryam. Akaryaha Atma. Therefore, it is Nityam. It doesn't have a beginning. Anything that has a beginning, that is a product, what will happen to that in the pralaya? Karane praliyate. It is dissolved in the cause. An effect will be dissolved into the cause. A pot is dissolved into the cause, clay. Therefore, any product, any effect is not permanent. It is impermanent, anityam. So anything which has beginning is anityam. Beginning means beginning or karanam. Anything which has karanam is anityam. If it has a karanam, therefore it becomes a karyam. Karyatvat anityam. But Atma is free from karanam. It is free from adihi. Adihi means karanam. Therefore, therefore atma is nityam yatha prithivyadi prithivyadi vashakara gives an example yatha prithivyadi prithivi etc all this in the pralaya it goes into its cause prithivi therefore it's a product because it is a product therefore it is resolved into its cause which is apaha apaha is also a product which resolves into the karanam agni so a product as karanam because it has got a karanam therefore it comes into existence at a particular time particular period therefore when it's resolved it goes back into the cause therefore they are anityam atma is not like that akaryatvat nityam and also sarvakaranatvat being the cause of everything therefore it is akaryam atma is not a karya it is not a karya akaryatvat therefore it is nityam being not a product therefore atma is nityam permanent any product will be anityam karyatvat and atma is not a product akaryatvat so therefore na tasya karanam asti brahma for brahma there is no cause into which it can resolve it's been prilieyet if it is a cause then brahma can resolve into that but it doesn't have a cause therefore there is nothing into which the atma brahma can resolve into so there is no resolution for brahma there is no resolution for brahma so therefore it is not an a karya it is not a product it is not a cause it is not a product brahman has no cause therefore it is not a product and sarva karanatvat it is akaryam abhinna nimitta upadana karanam brahma abhinna nimitta upadana karanam brahma so therefore the word here the anadi is connected to the nityam since it has no cause therefore it is nityam if it has a cause then brahma would be the karya and the karyam brahma will be resolved into its karanam but that is not there for brahma therefore brahma is nityam why it is nityam is being explained because it doesn't have a cause since it doesn't have a cause therefore it is not a product therefore it is nityam there is another way also we can explain the word nityam through anadi has been explained now then through ananta also we can explain that we will see in the next class om पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ
धन्यवादः
Sharan ji,
yes,
have a question after you stop recording.
Dhanyavad
ji, yes.